Welcome to Tech Savvy. My name is Lee Newman, and I'm the Executive Director of Campus Operations for the LaGrange campus of West Georgia Technical College. And we are continuing to do amazing things out there, and we just would love to have you there and come visit. And if you have any questions, you can always visit us on our website at www.westgatech.edu. The answers are right there. Or you can give us a call or come by and visit us on our LaGrange campus. We have a very special guest to star today. He was our nominee for Teacher of the Year, or the Rick Perkins Award. He went to the college-wide competition and he won for the college. Then we sent him to Atlanta to the statewide and he made in the top final. So that just proves he's special. Of course, he's from LaGrange, so that makes him extra special. So Dr. David Worthen is our biology instructor and our science teacher at West Georgia Tech, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
And I'm going to start, but I want to know, I haven't had a chance to visit with you, so this is kind of my opportunity to find out more about you. Tell me about yourself. You know, where have you been? How'd you get here? You know, just a little bit about yourself.
I'm a native of Mississippi. I graduated my undergrad degree from Mississippi Valley State University. I received my Doctor of Chiropractic from Sherman College of Chiropractic in South Carolina. And I've been teaching on the college level for about 6 years, 7 years.
So this hasn't been something you've been doing for a long time?
Not a long time. I'm fairly young in education. I've been teaching at multiple levels. Mm-hmm. I've taught seventh grade science. I did that for a year. I went to grad school and now I'm teaching college.
What do you think about technical education?
I think technical education is great. I mean, I think this is a great opportunity for a lot of people to learn the trade and the skills that they want to learn to get jobs immediately and to be able to affect their communities right now.
Mm-hmm. Well, so why technical education as compared to the university systems? I mean, you've had experience in both now.
Well, with our technical education system, we have 24 colleges, and with those colleges, we're able to affect our students in the communities in which they live in, especially right here in LaGrange. So they're able to come here, they're able to get an education, they're able to work there, support our families, because a lot of our technical education students, oftentimes they will be adult students and they'll have their families and they'll have jobs and responsibilities. So they're able to be right here at home with their family, with those responsibilities, and they're able to pursue whatever career that they choose to.
It's like a dual, somebody doing one full-time job, and then this would be in the education part, another one. So mm-hmm. You kind of fill in the blanks and then have children and all. It's kind of crazy when you get to that point. You have a lot of students with that situation, don't you?
We do. I've had students that were working, you know, two jobs. They were supporting three kids, and they still were able to come in, take our courses, and be successful.
See, that's what I want our viewers to understand. It's not impossible. It can be done. It can be done at a later age.
It can.
And we're so flexible out there with our schedule that we can work around any other work schedules. All right, you teach. Tell me what the classes are that you teach.
I teach general biology, I teach microbiology, and I teach anatomy and physiology.
And you were telling me how some classes are set up for business classes, some are set up for criminal justice, and others for the health sciences, correct?
Yes. Our anatomy and physiology classes, most of those are truly geared towards the health sciences. That means that are going to be students that are going towards the nursing. Maybe they're going to be radiological technology students, or they're going to be rad techs.
Mm-hmm.
But when we look at general biology is going to be for almost anybody. With your business administration, technology, criminal justice, they're going to be required to take those general biology classes. So mm-hmm. It gives them an opportunity to learn a little bit about science, and those classes are going to be transferable.
Well, that was my next question. Is I know we probably have students here from in the summertime that are going to school other places, and they could get some credit.
Correct.
College credit from your classes.
Correct. I've had students from Columbus State. I've had students from Clayton State. I've had students from all around. I've had students from as far away as Marietta down in LaGrange.
Well, you must You must know how to do something, right?
Hopefully.
Do you teach anything online?
Not currently, but we are working on some classes that could potentially be online. Mm-hmm. We know that our online classes are the wave of the future, and they allow much more flexibility. So you don't just get the regular in-classroom instruction, although our classes are web enhanced. So we use internet components along with our classes.
Right, right. Do you use a lot of illustrations on the internet and or mm-hmm. videos from the internet?
We use a lot of videos. Myself personally, I like art, so I do a lot of drawings in my class. So we do a lot of drawings, we do a lot of video. We also use websites through our publishers that allow us to give online assignments, as well as they have assignments that require them to watch a video and they answer questions about that video. And it may give them different illustrations for that video or that particular process.
Well, it sounds like to me that's one of the things that I think is most attractive about technical education is hands-on. Mm-hmm. Because some people just can't learn from lectures only.
Well, that's why we include a lab component. Mm-hmm. And with our lab component, we have a lot of hands-on activities. One of those activities that we're going to do next week is DNA testing. We're going to be able to look at some DNA, take some DNA samples from a cheek swab. We also do blood typing. So we allow our students to type their own blood if they don't know it, or if they want to confirm what they know from their hospital experience. Mm-hmm. They can see what their blood types are. So they learn it and they do it.
That's very, very interesting. And of course, the pizza, piece of pizza that they used in the crime scene mm-hmm. for something, I think in New York or mm-hmm. something, that's got the DNA on it, and that's the key.
It is, and that ties into some of our criminal justice, why they need general biology, because they're able to see how DNA works, and they get to learn why it's the why it gets passed along and what it means for a cell and what it means for a human being.
And it's just each individual has their own.
Yeah. Everybody has their own unique DNA, and it basically makes up who they are. It tells us why we do what we do. It tells us how to do that particular thing.
That is so amazing. And then our students get that knowledge and are able to use it and apply it. And like I used as an example, that would make sense to me now.
Right.
Why I would need to know, because that's proof right there.
Right.
All right. Tell me about some of your students.
Well, we've got a wonderful group of students. Most of our students that are coming into the health science programs, they have to come through me, so I'm kind of a gatekeeper. And being the gatekeeper, I get to see the most dedicated students there are, because oftentimes they're very detail-oriented, and they're problem solvers. Most of them are curious. They want to know why. A lot of our students, they've already worked in the medical field, so they have some knowledge about the medical field, and they want to know, well, is this why we do this particular procedure? Or if this happens, then blank. And so they start trying to develop
that
ideas.
Problem solving skills, those are so essential in every facet of, you know, any kind of employment. That's what they want, is those problem solving skills.
Right. That is definitely something that we're looking for. We're not looking for robots. We want people that can come in and they can problem solve. With my students, I talk to them about life. Life is very... it's very diverse. And some of the, right. And some of the things that we teach in the textbook, we try to tell you what's normal. But when you work in a hospital setting, it's not always normal. Sometimes you will get things that are a little different. And we want them to be able to deal with a little different. We don't want them to just, you know, look at a person and go, well, this doesn't quite look like it looks in the textbook.
Right. And, right. Well, that's the key, though, in pretty much anything, is you've got to give the student foundation, because they're not going to see exactly what they're learning in the classroom
right.
when they get into the real world.
Right. Well, for the most part, they will, but they really need to know how to deal with what happens when it doesn't look like the textbook.
Mm-hmm.
And oftentimes in our classes, our microbiology classes for certain, we do a lot of case studies. We talk about case studies. We talk about what if, what happened to this person. So in that class, you need critical thinking skills, and you also need to be able to reason well.
Mm-hmm.
And that's something that we work on. We give them activities to allow them to express themselves in that
manner. So you handle them, you give them the facts up front.
Correct.
The different options that it could be, and then they have to choose the option or decide from an option, and then see what happens with that.
Correct.
Right?
That's one possible route. They also are doing research in those things.
Mm.
For example, if they get a particular disease, they may have to research that disease before they can answer the questions about the case study. Oftentimes, there'll be diseases that they've never heard of. You know, sometimes it's something really exotic, or sometimes it's something that they've heard of, but they don't really know what it's about.
Well, it just sounds so over my head at this point. Let's take a break and come back and we'll talk some more about what your classes are like and what your students are going to become when they finish.
Okay.
We'll be right back. Welcome back to Tech Savvy. We have Dr. Wortham here today with us, and he is so interesting to talk to. He's got such a positive approach to teaching science, which is not my strong suit at all, but he's making it sound like it might be something I want to pursue. But tell us about your students. What are the challenges that your students have? Because it's not an easy area to learn, and it's not an easy area to catch on to if you haven't had a good background in that area. So I want to hear some stories about it.
Well, oftentimes the challenge with teaching science is teaching science. Most people have, by the eighth grade, they've fallen out of love with science. And so, like you said, science may not be your thing. Science is your thing. You just don't know it yet. So it's okay. My job to kind of make it your thing.
Right.
So oftentimes when they come in, most of them will kind of have a bad opinion about science. So I don't like science. Stuff is boring. It's kind of like mathematics in a way. Oftentimes mathematics gets a bad rap because when you start throwing numbers in with words and word problems and things, that's basically what science is. But for the most part, I have to nurture that curiosity they have. When they're able to come in and ask questions about things, that's the scientific mind. Scientists always want to know how. They always want to know why. So when my students come, they're always concerned that they're not going to be able to get it. But once they start asking questions, they realize, I can understand this. And part of what I do is I like to explain it in the terms that I understand. Oftentimes when we go in these classroom settings, you expect a teacher to kind of use all these big words. And in science, we use a lot of big words. But I also try to let them know that I can talk to you on that level, and I'm going to bring you where you want to be. You know, so
and you were there at one point.
I was there at one point. You know, we all start off at the same level.
All right.
And by the time they finish with my class, they should be near or ready to exceed where I am. You know, and that's the lofty goal that I have for them. Uh-huh. Now, where I am, it has taken a lot of years to get there. And when they get on the job, they're going to learn some things that I may not have ever heard of, because science is always evolving. And that's our students. They're going to be on the cutting edge of technology. They're going to be learning new things. They're going to be discovering some new things. We're not just working on something that they do for a couple years and they retire and they go on. Most of them are going to be pioneers in their fields.
Well, that's an interesting approach. So in other words, you're going to tell them what you know,
right?
But that's going to get them interested and they want to pursue more.
Correct. Currently in one of my classes, I have a student that wants to be a surgeon.
Really?
Right. And I look at her and I go, you are really making me proud, because I know that this student is going to be one of my products.
Right. Right. And you want them to be successful.
Correct.
So, and so you've got, how do you handle that? Some students are coming in like, I just don't want to do this. I don't know what I want to do. Da, 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 da. You've got to convince them that they're successful. They can be successful.
Well, they're already convinced that they can be successful.
Good.
I just have to convince them that we have a vested interest in their success. With me teaching mostly health science students, those students are going to be the same students that take care of us in the future. So I have to make sure that these students that will be taking care of me when I get older, because I won't be, you know, as young as I am now.
Yeah, we all do old.
Right,
we're going to
get aged quite a bit. And I want to make sure that if something's not working, that my students can take care of me. Nothing would do me better than being able to look up and see one of my students taking care of me when I possibly can't take care of myself.
Well, that's pretty admirable, because that's a lofty goal. But we don't want anybody to graduate from West Georgia Tech that is not able to be productive and be competent and excel.
Correct.
So we push them.
We do. We do. We push them. We train them to the limits of training. We do everything we can to make sure they get the best experience and they get the best education possible. But even in getting that best education, we still have goals of making them the best. So we have to make sure that we're able to kind of separate certain people from others that may be a little squeamish when it comes to stuff like blood, from people that, you know, may not be able to perform the job. We try to make sure they're able to do that. But from time to time, There may be one or two that may not like it.
They're not meant to do that.
Or they may not be meant to do that. That happens as well.
Well, I like the terminology you use about your classes or the gatekeeper, mm-hmm. because if a student comes in there and takes it and realizes that's not their field, then they haven't wasted a lot of time because you're one of the first classes that they take.
Correct.
And you can certainly, by the time you get to know them, suggest other areas.
Right. And sometimes we can see early on that they don't have that passion for the science. Maybe they don't like it. I had a student that started out in the health science program, and she ended up going into criminal justice, you know. So her time spent in our anatomy and physiology programs weren't wasted because she may go on to be a CSI.
Mm-hmm.
She may be a crime scene investigator. So that's going to help her in her future career. So it wasn't lost. She was able to look at the sciences and see, maybe this is not for me. And that's admirable.
But she learned enough that would help her, like with the DNA
information
that you say.
Correct.
That is just remarkable how well it works together like that. What do you think of West Georgia Tech?
I think it's a great institution. I love the counties that we represent, the counties that we service, especially here in Troup County, especially the city of LaGrange itself. And we receive students from all over the place. So to be able to reach out to Harris County and Troup County and the surrounding counties, and to be able to service them and to teach them and, you know, increase their workforce, I really enjoy working for West Georgia Tech.
I think it's a pretty cool place.
Yeah, it is.
We have a lot of good people working there, very hard, but everybody's focused on our students.
It is.
Because we want those students to succeed. Sometimes
Right.
we have to make decisions that we don't like and they don't like, but it's for the best interest of the students, and that's one of those rules that we go by.
Correct.
Whatever's best for the student.
Correct.
So if you have a student that's listening right now, a potential student listening, and you say, you know, they can't decide whether they want to go into it, what would you say to them?
Go for it. I'm always an advocate of pursuing your dreams. You're going to miss 100% of the shots that you don't take. And that's an old basketball adage. So if you want to go into the health sciences, if you want to go into any science, because our sciences are transferable, go ahead and start with us. Give us a try, right?
You don't have anything to lose.
No, you don't. I mean, you always gain a new experience by trying the classes. I've had students that may have taken the class before, and they come and take it again because they want to learn more. They want to know more about where we are. And every time that they take it, they get something slightly different every time, because not only are they learning from me, but I also learn from the students. You know, sometimes
Really?
They will give me a new way of looking at things. So I want to be able to talk to that student, for them to come in, to sit in our classes, to take that class, and to learn something from it. If you learn something from it, is this something that you want to continue to do?
And, I mean, it's so important to let them know they've got the ability to do it.
Correct.
You've got to give them the confidence that they've got something very valuable with their skills that they're learning.
Correct.
Tell me about your lab. What all equipment do you have in your lab, or how do you use your lab for your instruction?
Well, we have a standard lab set up. With our lab in LaGrange, we're a multi-use lab. With that lab, we're teaching the biology, we're teaching the microbiology, we're teaching anatomy and physiology. With anatomy and physiology, we have certain labs that we perform that are kind of like the health sciences, like we were saying about the blood typing. We also do the cheek swabs with the DNA. Something else that we do is we do urinalysis, so students are able to understand how urine formation happens, the contents of urine, how it affects your health.
Mm-hmm.
Because when we start looking at the fluids of the body, the fluids of the body tells you a lot about a person's health, so they're able to look at those particular things. We're
mm-hmm.
also able to look at respiratory function. So we have spirometers where the students can breathe into them, and they can look at things like their tidal volume or their lung capacity, all
mm-hmm.
of those different things.
Mm-hmm.
We also look at the microbiology labs. With the microbiology, they're able to grow bacteria. That's the biggest thing that we grow. And we're able to study the formation of that bacteria, how it interacts with this environment, how it grows in that environment, what we can do to kill that bacteria, but it wants to kill the bacteria. So we have different experiments that allow us to do that.
That is so amazing, because the best way to learn is to see it happen.
Correct. And we even have an experiment where they're able to bring in some of their household products. And we've tested some of those household products, and the students were very shocked as to what products were killing better than the others.
That is impressive. I did that science project when I was like in the eighth grade,
yeah.
Long time ago.
Yeah, we're doing it now on a bigger scale.
I bet, I bet. All right, when we come back, I want you to tell our viewers, give your presentation that you used to get you in the top group of the teachers of the year in the state of Georgia.
Okay.
Would you do that for us?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, thank you so much.
No problem. Greetings, I'm Dr. David Wortham of West Georgia Technical College, and today I have the opportunity to talk to you about technical education in Georgia. Technical education in Georgia is changing the way Georgians look at the world and the world views Georgia. We're able to change the way the world views Georgia because we're building something special. We're building a globally competitive, well-educated workforce. We're able to build this workforce because we're able to reach our students where they live. We're not just reaching where they live in the physical sense with the 24 colleges we have around the state, but we're reaching them academically. With our adult education programs, we're able to give these students an opportunity to earn a GED, and this GED makes those students much more attractive to employers. We're also able to reach our students in high school. We reach them with our dual enrollment program and our Move On Ready program. With these two programs, these programs allow these students to not only earn credits toward their high school graduation, but also earn credits toward their college graduation. This gives them a leg up in the collegiate community. One such student that I had once upon a time, Caitlin. Caitlin was a Move On Ready student. She joined us her senior year of high school. In her senior year of high school, she decided she wanted to be a nurse. And in pursuing this nursing degree, she had to take the science classes. Well, Caitlin, like anyone else trying something new, she decided that she was afraid, and she voiced that opinion. And I was able to sit down with Caitlin, and I was able to explain to her that we have a vested interest in her success, especially in the technical college community. We know that Caitlin will be working in the community, she'll be working on each of us, and we're gonna explain it in terms that she understands. We're gonna be able to give her that future that she's looking for. So after a nice talk, Caitlin went from a person that was mildly interested in science to a person that was highly intrigued by science. So I was able to watch this wonderful student in a year and a half transform into this person that is ready for the real world. Caitlin's story doesn't end with me. Caitlin is going to be in our health science program where she's going to receive training from our world-class nursing staff. In this program, they have a simulator that simulates giving birth. So before Caitlin even reaches the hospital floor, she's going to go through the process of delivering a baby for someone. That's the kind of education that we're providing. When technical colleges work, Georgia works.
That was awesome. Where do I sign? You're a perfect example of why we're doing so well out at West Georgia Tech. You are an unbelievable example for our students, and thankfully we have more of you out there. I mean, we've got some excellent teachers out there that care about their students, and so we want to make sure that they're successful.
We do. I'm proud to be a representative of West Georgia Tech and the wonderful faculty and staff that we have. And as the Rick Perkins winner for West Georgia Technical College, I was able to actually go out and meet other Rick Perkins winners from around the state. And in the technical college system, we have a great bunch of instructors.
Very impressive, aren't they? Well, we do good stuff. I don't think that's right grammar, but we do. But thank you very much for joining us. Thank you so much, Dr. Wortham, for being here with me today. And will you promise to come back?
Yes, ma'am.
And tell us some more great stories.
I will.
All right. Thank you again for all you do.
Thank you.
And thank you again for joining us. We'll see you at the next episode of Tech Savvy.